Feminist Creativist presents a word for every generation that knows no fashion.
Greetings. I hope and trust I find you well, my dear friends. We have one more experience as we consider the topic. Your aunt will not always believe in you. This is a sequel from The Problem Fixer. And I invite you to the book of 1 Samuel. We're still at verse number 28 and in chapter 17. This is what the Bible says. David's oldest brother, Eliab, listened as he spoke to the man and became angry with him. "Why did you come down here?" he asked. "Who did you leave those few sheep with in the wilderness? I know your arrogance and your evil heart. You came down to see the battle." Verse 29. "What have I done now?" protested David. "It was just a question." Verse 30, "Then he turned from those beside him to other in front of him and asked about the offer. The people gave him the same as before." May the good Lord bless us as we go into this word. Let us pray before then. Kind and gracious Father in the heavens above, thank you, dear Lord, for the privilege of calling upon your name. Dear Lord, you have set us on serious missions. It is very possible. While we understand what you have said for us, while we have opportunities that we seek to seize, our own brothers, sisters, and parents may not believe in us. But dear Lord, thank you for believing in us. And may you continue to give us the strength and the courage to achieve that which you have set for us. In Jesus' name we pray and we ask. Amen. My dear friends, just allow me to raise 5 points. And one thing that I find here is when you are inquisitive, you are bound to rub some people the wrong way. You are bound to, ruffle the feathers because you are asking too many questions. What is happening here is David is coming through as a sibling to Eliab, and he's asking a question, simple question: what will be done to whoever solves this problem? These are people who ask the right questions, but somehow they just get to irritate those who listen. And if you want to know, you have a big brother mentality, which is a big problem. This is the Eliab mentality. The Eliabs are those people who, when their subordinates, especially in the workplace, ask questions, they respond with anger. They are quick to get irritated by whosoever asks questions. Why are you angry? Because someone is asking a question. Should that be a reason to be angry? But for you to be responding with anger, then you shall know you have an Eliab mentality. You want the subordinates to remain where they are, clamped up and shut up their dark holes. Do not even say anything. Point number two, you want to check if you have an Eliab mentality and you do not believe in the potential of others, even though David sees these men who think so low of themselves as the armies of the Lord. Eliab cannot see his brother as the problem fixer. And why do I say so? When you ask questions not to understand, but to draw a conclusion, you have a big brother mentality. Why do I say so? Listen to how Eliab goes on. "Why did you come down here?" That's a good question. But this is the person who has already arrived and told them, "I bring greetings from our father Jesse. I bring this particular cream from our father Jesse," and he gives them the provisions. And this brother chooses to forget why David has just walked all the way to his brothers only to remind him, "Why are you here?" Before he asks the question, listen to Eliab. Now he goes on to his conclusions. Who did you leave those few sheep with? This is a derogatory tone. He is supposed to take care of the few, not the many sheep, the few sheep in the wilderness, while Eliab continues to march for 40 days without a solution. All he does every morning is wake up to go and shout a battle cry in the queue. But at least David is doing something in the wilderness. He's taking care of sheep. At least David is not irresponsible. As he leaves the sheep, he leaves them in the custody of somebody else. But David does not even go on to answer these questions. He does not even respond to say, oh, by the way, big brother, what have you been doing for 40 days before I came? You know, making a difference and being a problem fixer, you do not always respond to every question. But as if we're not yet done with Eliab, listen to what Eliab says. Eliab continues to misunderstand the young man. He says, I know your arrogance and your evil heart. Brother Eliab, now you're being too harsh. It's one thing to talk about the sheep. It's something else to call your young brother arrogant, to call him evil-hearted. You came down to see the battle. Which battle, by the way? You have spent 40 days marching. There is no battle. The young man has been here since early in the morning. Nothing is happening. And you think he has come to see the battle. No. He's the one who's come to fight. When we do not believe in those who are close to us, we miss to see them as the ones who are the victors. They are the warriors. They are the battle changers. They are the game changers. When you fail to see this, at point number three, you begin to think everyone is a spectator and you are the main actor. That is the Eliab mentality. Those who are actually at the center of the storm, you think they are spectators when you are in the terraces. You mischaracterize everyone. That's the problem with being Eliab. Big brother mentality. You think people are there to find solutions from you. When you are inactive, you are doing nothing. You have no new ideas. You are not even researching. Opportunities are being presented to you. You have an opportunity to be rich. You have an opportunity to get a wife. You have an opportunity to take care of your family. You are not seizing the opportunity. When people come in and they take advantage of the opportunities, you call them arrogant. You call them evil-hearted. Big brother mentality. Point number four. Look at this. He goes on to say, you are arrogant. You are evil. Why? Why this whole bad blood? Why this bad blood? Why should the young man be relegated to taking care of the sheep? The few sheep out there. I need you to hang around until we get to the end of the rise of David. When he shall respond, I am David, the son of Jesse. Man, stick around. I'm telling you, 3 weeks from now, you are going to get why this arrogance, why this evil. When people are suddenly arrogant towards you, they are either threatened by you or you have outshined them. You have come out a better man, better woman than they are. They can't stomach your presence. This is what is happening. And 3 weeks from now, I will answer this question. But what am I saying unto you at point number five as we come to an end? I want you to take note how David responds at verse number 30. Having asked in verse 29, what have I done wrong? It was just a question. Listen to verse 30. Then he turned to those beside him, to others in front of him, and asked about the offer. The people gave him the same answer as before. Now, there's need for us to turn from the Eliabs. There are Eliabs in the workplace. Some of them are superiors. Some of them are colleagues. They are Eliabs. Until and unless you turn from an Eliab, you are going to be watered down. Your strength, your drive, your oomph is going to be sapped because you have people who do not believe in you. You have people who do not want to give you a chance. You have people who do not think you can even be the problem fixer. Make it your natural response. Turn from such people. Walk away from them. Yes, they are your Eliabs. They are your brothers. You have known them for a long time. But if they do not believe in your dream, they do not believe in your vision, you have no business being in their midst. Walk away. Turn to those who will tell you how you can go about realizing your ambition. Before we part, I know some of us have been hurt by the sentiments and the statements of the Eliabs. I want to pray for a healing and even an encouragement that you may continue on your path. Let us pray, my dear friends. Kind and gracious Father in the heavens above, thank you, dear Lord, for the privilege of opportunities. In our workspaces, some of us have been discouraged left, right, and center. How I pray, dear Lord, that you may give us the wisdom to walk away and turn to those who are going to feed into our energy, those who are going to plow into our vision and our ambition. They are there, dear Lord. They are not absent in the workspace. Give us the eyes to associate with such so that we can achieve more in spite of our brothers and sisters not believing in us. But above all, our brother, King Jesus, believes in us. No wonder he has decided that we become heirs of the kingdom and co-rule with him. What more confidence could we ask for besides this? Be with us until we meet again next Monday. In Jesus' name we ask, amen.